Welcome back to the NepsterLems level zombie commentary video series. And today we're going to be starting the third rank, which is called Planet. And so pretty much this is part of the pack where the difficulty starts picking up significantly. So it's pretty much the rank where things start getting quite hard and will stay that way for the rest of the pack. Although there's still some breeders here and there. This is the rank where we are pretty much doing away with the extra rare things, and then we just get into the puzzly levels right away. I don't think there's even any further extra everything levels in the pack. But I could be remembering wrong, though, especially since I have not seen the planet, sun, and neutron star levels for a very long time. Whereas black hole, I've seen them very recently, just last week. Pretty much all the levels at that rank, just last week. Once I got myself unstuck on Black Hole 1 and proceeded to smash the rest of the pack. Smash through the rest of the pack, I should say. I didn't, totally destroy it, the pack, and so that's not playable or anything. You can pretty much think of the Comet and Moon ranks as, bonus ranks. They do feel like part of the main pack anyway, despite them just being extra favorite things. Starting with the planet rank, this is definitely the rank where it's pretty much not a lot of these levels aren't as open-ended anymore. There's still some levels there where there are multiple possibilities, but there's definitely less degrees of freedom to carve out your own solution. And so there aren't as many as there were in the except everything levels in the moon and common ranks. And another thing you may notice as we go along in this video series is that, you will start to notice some characteristics of Nepster's levels. So, in particular, I noticed after quite some time that Nepster's levels tend to be small to medium in size, with very minimal skill sets, that still end up making a very deceptively difficult level. So, needless to say, Nepster's levels are pretty much the type of, level where the solution is just hidden in plain sight, but it's hidden extremely well. So that's what makes them very difficult. And it's especially the case in the Sun and Neutron Star ranks. Planet, there were a couple of them, but I do run one major roadblock, but that will be in the next video, since pretty much the plan for the rest of the video series is that because these have at least 20 levels, the remaining ranks have at least 20 levels each. I would pretty much be splitting them into two videos, of 10 levels each. Except for the black hole rank, where there will be 10 for the first one, and then 11 for the second video for that rank. So yes, that's pretty much the plan for the remaining videos of the series, which means I believe this should be done in 8 more videos then. So for a total of 10 videos. And it seems that the... for pretty much every video that I upload to my YouTube channel, there will be a copyright notice where the video will just simply be blocked in Russia. Because for my two videos so far, for this video series, they have both been blocked in Russia, but it's fine everywhere else. So, oh well. I don't think there's even any member who's from Russia in the Lemmings forums, but I could be wrong there though. Especially since we are all scattered all over the world here. That's pretty much a quick overview of what's going to be happening with the rest of the video series and pretty much the pack in general. What is characterized by these levels and the remaining ranks. Let's go ahead and get into the video series now. So, to start us off, we have Planet 1, introducing Miners. As the title says, we pretty much only have miners here. Let me find a replay here. Alright, so even though you only have miners here, it's still not a completely trivial level whatsoever. So first one with mine here, and the next one with mine before the first one. This is enough to turn the third one around, who will mine to the left and cancel out the other two. And then, next one, before the first one, going back to the left, will mine as well. He will get over the terrain here, the wall, I should say. Yeah, and then the next one will mine before the bear trap here. Well, far away from the bear trap. Yeah, because the point is, we're trying to get back to the right, yeah, to mine this guy free. Yeah, so I do that by mining here as well. Well, actually, it wasn't really necessary since, yeah, one of them turned around in the meantime, so I could just do it right here. Yep, and then finally, all there's left to do is to just mine to get down to the exit, and that's it. So, we finished with two miners here. Where did the other guy go? Oh, he actually bunched up with the other guy. That's pretty interesting. Ah, that's very, very fascinating. Yippee! And I think it just happens to be the right spot, too. Yeah, that I chose for the last miner. So that happened. And two miners left over, so yeah. As you can see, not all 10 of them are needed. Although you could certainly use all 10 if you wanted to. And then the next one, Planet 2. Introducing Climbers. So yes, another low where you only have one skill here. Yep, Climbers. And there's also three lemmings, but this time you only need to save one. Yeah, don't be fooled by this though. Yeah, even though there are only climbers here, this is definitely not a trivial climbers only level. Yeah, you still have to think about the correct time to assign the climber skill. And yeah, it might be best if I zoom this out. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 exits and 3 entrances. Which means only one comes out of each entrance here. So yeah, it's pretty much just all about observing where the lemmings go and then just assigning climbers as is needed. Yeah, and I don't quite remember what the solution is right now, but I think it just involves syncing up like lemmings going into traps or something like that. Yeah, so that one of them gets by, yeah, unharmed. Yeah, so at this time, yeah, at the 14-second mark, I go ahead and assign these two climbers. Yeah, this one after he turns back to a lemming. Otherwise, he's just going to go out this way and then fall into oblivion. Yeah, whereas for this guy, this is after he turns to the right. Because otherwise, he would just climb in and die into the rope trap here. Yeah, and then finally, I also assigned this guy a climber as well. Yeah, so that he gets past this the staircase here. So yes, let's go ahead and see what happens here in the solution. So, I think this guy, he just simply goes to the exit. Yeah, so he doesn't really interact with the others here. So yes, this is just needed to... Oh! Wait, why did he... Oh, yeah, I didn't realize that. That's an overhang. Yeah, that's why he got blocked. So yeah, I guess he does interact with the others then. So yes, this is needed so that the lemming from the right, yeah, is able to get by without getting killed by the trap. And then I think the next thing is something similar that will happen too. So yeah, it's to allow the one coming from the left to get by the trap, and therefore into this exit here. So yes, even though there's only climbers here, it is not completely trivial whatsoever. Yeah, because you still need to decide when to like assign the climbers. Yeah, you can't just like arbitrarily assign them and hope that you will stumble upon the solution. No. You have to observe where they go and then assign them as needed. Yeah, when they are facing the correct direction. Planet 3, another minor problem. Yes, so we are finally into levels where we have more than one skill type here. And yeah, definitely not an easy one. So first one becomes a climber. And then mine here. Yeah, he'll come back to the left. And then we mine here. Yeah, so that we could get to the crowd here. And then we bash. Okay, and then finally all that's left to do is to build to get up here. And then finally mine to get to the exit. Yeah, and here you have to take care of this climber here. Yeah, make sure that he does not go off here and die. Of course, that's very easy to avoid. Yeah, since you could, like, for example, use a different lemming to do the building. Yeah, because in this case, the climber would have made another detour. Yeah, going back to the left. But yeah, nice level here. And a bit under 3 minutes. Planet 4, the block store. Yeah, and because I'm only doing 10 levels, yeah, per video, for the rest of the series, except for the black hole rank, or at least for the second video for that rank, yeah, where I would be doing, where I'll be doing 11, yeah, these will definitely be a lot shorter than the first two videos of the series. Yeah, as a matter of fact, I got pretty surprised that the second video ended up almost an hour long. Yeah, but I guess that's what happens when you do the entire rank. Yeah, even though it has 15 levels and whatnot. Anyway. Planet 4. Yeah, I think I rare this one. This one is a little bit tricky. Yeah, one of everything skill set. So, after one of me, I max out the release rate here. Pretty sure that's just for some timing here. Okay, block here at the end there. And then I mine with the first lemming coming back to the left. Yeah, everyone gets by except for the last lemming who turns back to the right. Yeah, and I believe that is important because, yeah, we need two to go on ahead, I think. Actually, not quite, yeah. He actually ended up turning around before the miner was done. Yeah, and then we go ahead and dig here. Yeah, and then finally bash to get to the exit. Yep, and that's pretty much it already. No, I am wrong. It is a one of everything though, but there's no bomber. Yeah. So it's just 7 skill types. So it's almost a one of everything. Yeah, just 1 skill type missing. Yeah, generally when we say that, it simply means all 8 skill types are present. Yeah, but in this case it is not. Yeah, because the bomber is missing. And so to end the level, we just nuke the blocker. But you can also press the escape key, yeah, to go straight into the post results screen. Planet 5, the Earth Cube. Yeah, I think I ran this one being pretty difficult, but it just involves like pretty good timing, I think, and also knowing how to use the skills here. And you will definitely come to realize that, like, especially if you play through the pack, that what makes Nepster's levels pretty difficult is not only because the solutions are hidden in plain sight, yeah, very well. But also because there are also plenty of possibilities that look like they could work, but they don't. Alrighty. And then send up a climber. So, interesting that it's the Barber of Seville here. Yeah, for a dirt level. Okay, dig here, and then... Yeah, at this time, yeah, after a couple of strokes, yeah, I'll go ahead and send up another climber. Yeah, and then I mine so that the second climber can turn back to the left, so that he can mine the crowd free. Yeah, in the meantime, the one going to the right will patch up the gap. And yeah, plenty of leeway there. Yep, so that's where the two builders are. And they finally just climber bomb the pole away, and that's it. Oh, the wall. No, I don't bomb. Okay. Yeah, looks like I dig instead. Yeah, and then I mine to delay the crowd, yeah, to get the digger enough time. Yeah. In the meantime, the climber coming back to the left is able to go out and die over there. Yeah, and that is your only loss for the low. So yeah, that's the reason why you cannot bomb there. Okay, yeah. That I did not mirror over here. But yeah, that is it. So just a bomber left over. Yeah, I don't think any solution uses it, but I could be wrong, though. Planet 6. Blockers forever. I think I remember this one. Though I could just wonder that there was, like, a time limit here, too. Yeah, maybe I'm confusing it with some other law. And as a matter of fact, I think that's from Uncharted, which came many years after NepsterLems. Alright, so block here. Yeah, and then that pretty much saves this entrance already. But I think we will do some further work with them. Yeah, I can't quite remember right now. So, bash. And then interrupt mid-stroke with a builder. Oh, and that's it already. Oh yeah, it was a lot easier than I thought. So, this should most definitely be a back route then. Yeah, I forgot that I solved this one pretty easily. But again, it's just simply due to how I have not seen these levels in a very long time. Planet 7, A Study in Scarlet. So this, right here, I introduced to you is the Level of the Year winner, yeah, in the contest that that this was nominated in. I don't remember which year it was. It might have been... It was either LOTY 2016 or LOTY 2017. Yeah, I think it was one of those two. But yeah, in that level of the year in which this level was nominated, yeah, this level ended up winning. So congrats to Nepster for that. And I can definitely see why, because this one is actually pretty good. Yeah, it's a difficult level. Yeah, I remember being stuck here for quite a while, but when I figured out the solution, I was like, oh wow, this is pretty good. So yes, I can't quite remember what it is right now though, but let's see. So yeah, I think I just simply let everyone collect here, and then yeah, with one of the last few, or last several I should say, yeah, I start digging here at the edge, and then I build, yeah, at the point where this wall is still high enough to contain them, yeah, this lemming still goes on. I had to do the work, and yeah, and it appears that it needs to be with another lemming with him as well. So then I go ahead and bash when we reach the wall. Oh, that's right. Yeah, I think we simply come out from the right side here. Yeah, and then build, and then before he falls out, then we go ahead and block. Yeah, and then we use the other lemming that was with him to mine the crowd free. And then finally, we build up to the exit, and that's it. So yes, very, very nice though. So, what makes this pretty difficult is that, yeah, you would think that the answer would be to, basically go out up here, but, if you do that, you will run out of skills. Yeah, and therefore, will not get the level solved. So, this is actually pretty difficult to see, actually. But, that's what makes the level pretty good, in my opinion. So, very, very nice puzzle to it. And also a pretty good-looking level, too. And, yes, from what I read in the level pack topic, how Nepster achieved these blocks and the fire tiles is still simply a lot of, like, erasing the red letter pieces that you see in the graphic style. So, I was like, oh, wow, that's pretty impressive. Yeah, I didn't even know that was possible. But, hey, you'd be surprised at what you can do with the... various pieces in the editor. Planet 8, 51 steps to heaven. Yeah, so this is almost like the whatchamacallit, comic 2 in a way, but like yeah, of course the design is very different though. But I can definitely see a bit of the design in there. Let's go. Yeah, just with some one more arrow was added at the top, too. Okay, send up a climber. I use the second lemming here. Okay, and then mine. Oh, yes, and then after a while, I'll go ahead and send up another climber here. Yeah, it appears it's for some timing here. Okay, and then I mine. And yes, this goes to show you that it is possible to cancel a miner when both are climbers. But it is extremely difficult to do so. Yeah, it has to be very, very precise. Yeah, and as a matter of fact, I didn't even remember that happening. Although now that I think about it, because it's very fiddly and everything, yeah, maybe it's not even required in the solution either. Yeah, I think it's very possible to do it without being so fiddly. Oh, yes, and then I go ahead and mine to the left here. And then I use another miner going out to the right to cancel the one going to the left. And also, this is just to stop the climber from going up here and falling down and splatting. Well, I guess I could just use a floater there, but then the only problem is that when this miner's done, he won't have a way to save himself, because we only have one floater. So that's pretty much why I did that. Yeah, to prevent that from happening to both climbers. Oh, no, I do not build to the exit, okay. Right, I think it's for, like, something right here, actually. Yeah, and then I build here. And then after a while, I block. Yeah, to turn the others to the right. Okay, then I start building the exit, but it took me quite a while before I did that, for some very strange reason. And then with the last time I'm going to left, I go ahead and mine the block of three. And then, yeah, I go ahead and build with the both of them to turn back to the right, and that's it. Yeah, somehow I don't think that's exactly intended. I want to say that the solution is far more impressive, the intended solution. But, yeah, well, this one works too, but it barely does, though, because there isn't really that many places for you to build in order to turn around. Planet 9, minor obstacles. Okay, this one I think I remember being pretty, being one of the harder ones too. So, oh no, there's another like near X of everything though. Yeah, but this time we are missing floaters, so it's not exactly a true X of everything. Yeah, similar to that one of everything though earlier in the video. Yeah, except that one isn't a true X of everything either. Yeah, since it was missing the bombers. All right, up here we're gonna go ahead and mine, and then block here. Okay, send up a climber. Okay, build, and then in the meantime, I go ahead and bash the cloud to the right too. And then I use the last builder going to the left, and it appears that I just use it to extend the basher. Yeah, because he's able to get through these obstacles as well. Yeah, and so we will stop right here. Okay, and then I set up another climber. Yeah, and then I bomb here. It appears it's to make the fall survivable. Yeah, it's currently splat height. Yeah, so we use the hole here to dig for a bit, and then we're gonna go ahead and mine down to the crowd. And then finally, all there's left to do is to bash to get to the exit, and that's it. Okay, and then do I use the bomber on the blocker? Yeah, I do. But it took me quite a while before I did so. So yeah, the pretty restrictive skill set is what makes this pretty difficult. As you really have to figure out how to like get through the low with the many obstacles in the way and the very, very limited skill set. Yeah, especially on the digging destructive skills. And then finally, for the last level for the video, Planet 10, jump in the ring. Yeah, I also remember this one being fairly difficult. Yeah, but it isn't like too bad. But you still need to think about how to do the low, especially since this is a builderless one. Yeah, and this is the type of low I tend to love a lot in Lemmings. So on the left side, I go ahead and set up a climber. Well, both of them. Yeah, the first two Lemming status. Okay, and then I go ahead and bomb. And then the second climber is going to use the bomber hole to bash. Okay, and then right here, we're going to go ahead and dig. Okay, and then we're going to go ahead and mine down to the crowd here. Yeah, this is enough for them to step up. And then, what else did I do? Oh, I give the climber a floater. Yeah, and then he's going to come back up the digger shaft that he made. Yeah, and then we're going to go ahead and start digging here. Make sure that there's no wall to his right. And then mine down to this crowd here. Yeah, this crowd could just proceed to the exit. Yeah, and then finally, all that's left to do is to bash the wall away, and that's it. Yeah, and luckily there isn't enough terrain here to keep the basher going, so that's why he stops. Yeah, and then in the meantime, the climber's just going to float back down safely. Yeah, as we do need to save everyone except for that bomber that we used at the beginning. Okay, so that was the first 10 levels of the Planet Break. So next time we will finish up the remaining 10 levels of the Planet Break. So I hope you enjoyed this video at the NepsterLems level solving commentary video series, and I'll see you all for the next one.